Hey everyone, welcome to another video. This video is gonna be about the Glaminatrix Silent Night eyeshadow palette. This was released, I think, at the start of November, and I finally got it. And I thought it would still be fun to do a video about it because I believe there's a pre-order and you can also get these as singles now. So I just want to tell you about the quality, about these shades, how I feel about this palette. I just want to do a look and try it out. So that's what we're gonna do. So before we get into this video, I quickly wanted to say thank you so much for the 1k subscribers. The day I'm filming this is the day I hit 1k, finally. This is what we've been working towards and we're finally here. I'm so excited to finally have 1k. And I couldn't have done it without you and all your support. So thank you so much. Now, the Silent Night eyeshadow palette is by the brand Glaminatrix. I have only tried a few singles from the brand. I have never tried an eyeshadow palette, but I was very, very curious to try more by them from the singles that I tried because those were so good. At first, I actually didn't want to buy this eyeshadow palette because I thought it's Christmas themed. Maybe it's a little bit too Christmas themed for me because I didn't know if I was gonna still like it after Christmas. So I was a little bit late with ordering it because I actually heard later that these singles you can quite easily pop out. They are magnetic in the pan. So I thought if I don't use this palette because it's too Christmas themed, I can still take out the singles, put them in another palette and see if I will use it more then. Because these shades are just so gorgeous. I just thought they were too gorgeous to skip. So that's why I decided to pick this up a little bit later. Now, I'm just gonna get you a little bit closer and then we're just gonna get into the look. I'm just gonna be trying this one out and see how I feel about it. I have very high expectations. So I already primed my eyelids with my trusty old Etos primer and I'm not entirely sure what to do with this actually because we have some different dark matte options and I don't know if I want to use them all in one look. I think I want to try this green in the crease. I want to see how that works and I definitely want to try this multi-chrome on the lid. It looks so pretty, like green, blue, silver, pink. Kind of makes me think of the multi-chrome shade in the Annette's Makeup Corner and Olin's Eye Giant Wools palette. So I might do a little bit of a comparison of those at the end and see if this is actually similar because you can still get this, but you can't get the Giant Wools palette anymore. So if you were eyeing that multi-chrome, then maybe this could be one to replace that one with. So I'm just gonna start out with that green shade and I'm just gonna work that into the crease and then see how we'll go. I just really want to try this green because I'm wearing green. I like to match my eyeshadow to my outfits. I feel like you can blend this out a little bit softer. It doesn't have to be super harsh right away, which is interesting for this palette that has so many dark mattes. You can still do some softer looks with it, I think. Yeah, one of my concerns with this palette was that it doesn't really have that many transition shades. It only has that one gingerbread shade that is kind of like a transition shade, but that doesn't really go with any of these mattes, in my opinion. So I was kind of thinking, how am I gonna do looks? But I feel like this is blending out pretty easily and it's not like it's so dark that it's unblendable if you go in with this shade first. Yeah, in a way, these mattes are pretty soft. At least this matte is pretty soft. This is the first matte that I've tried from Glaminatrix. But you can build it up. I just want to see how intense I can actually get this. This shade is not powdery at all. There's no kick up in the pan or anything like that. I feel like this is going on pretty easily. I don't really have trouble blending. I'm not even that precise. I don't have the most precise brush. And if you add more, it can kind of deepen it up. But it's not the type of matte that's like bam in your face, super dark right away and then you only can do a very dark look. So that's a very nice forested green shade. I think I wanna try something. I wanna try if I can use this Slay shade in the outer part of the crease as well. And I wanna see if I can kind of like mix these together, kind of deepen it up, see if those kind of work together. So I'm gonna take a crease brush that's a little more precise. This shade is a little bit more powdery in the pan. And I'm gonna apply it over here. Yeah, this is a very impactful shade. Wow, that's pigmented. That's crazy. I didn't expect that because the green was so like buildable, and this is like right away you get a crazy amount of pigment. Wow. Okay, I can blend it out. This is such an opaque shade. I do get a little bit of fallout. I'm gonna clean that up in a minute. Okay, so this look turned kind of blue, but that green worked quite well as a transition shade for the blue. So glad I tried this. I'm taking a little bit less and doing the same over here, but it still looks very, very pigmented. Wow. But now I'm taking a little bit less. I don't really see fallout. So I think I just had a little bit too much product on my brush. This is a blue shade. Wow. It looks a little bit more navy on the eye now. But in the pan it looks more like almost like a royal blue a little bit. I'm gonna go back in with the green and kind of blend this together. And then I'm just gonna take a clean brush and go over the edge a little bit. Not too much because I don't want it to be too blown out, but I do want a little bit more of a blend here. Okay, so this became a really dark, impactful look all of a sudden, but these mattes worked well so far. Now I just wanna go into the shade called Baubles. Is that how you say it? This is the multi-chrome in the palette. It looks so pretty and shifty in the pan. I'm just gonna apply it with my finger. Wow. So this is the first time I'm touching this shade, and just look at this. This is so shiny and shifty. That is crazy. Okay, this is a really soft shade, so I barely touched it. And I'm just gonna take what I have on my finger now and apply that. That is so shiny. Wow. That is so incredibly shiny. This shade is like next level. Wow. That shift is so, so pretty. I hope you can kind of see it. It is like green, pink, blue, silver, purple. There's so many shades in here. This is so pretty. I love that shade. And it's like, it's a little bit tacky feeling almost when you apply it. But it goes on very easily with a finger. Probably gonna have a little bit of glitter on my face, but I don't really mind that. Just look at this. That's already one of my favorite shimmers I've tried. This is so pretty, so shifty. This shade is on another level. Okay, I'm just gonna clean up the crease a little bit, because I have a lot of shimmers in the crease. And then I'm gonna take the blue again, just a little bit. And kind of deepen this up just a tiny bit. But the shimmer still really, really shines through. But it's just a little bit of more depth in the outer corner like this. Okay, this is crazy. This is a look. Okay, now I want to take a little bit of Fairy Lights and put that in the inner corner. I'm just going to take a pencil brush. This shade looks so... Ooh, this is a very like putty shade. You can really move it around. So I just dipped my pencil brush in the pan and almost like went right through the shade in the pan. So you have to be a little bit careful. I could press it back, but it's like kind of gold, silver, shimmery, very, very shiny. It also kind of makes me think of a shade in the Giant Wolves palette. It's not exactly the same. I feel like this almost has a little bit more of a greenish hue to it, but so pretty. This look is so, so shiny. I just realized that I forgot to film close-ups before I started applying these eyeshadows. So in the close-ups, you're gonna be seeing these eyeshadows, how they look a little bit used. It's just how it is sometimes. Okay, so what am I gonna do for the bottom? I think I wanna kind of keep it in this color family. I don't think I wanna make it like super messy, make this really warm and try and do all the shades. Sometimes I try and use all the shades in a palette in one look, but I just really wanna keep going with this vibe that I have now. So I think I'm just gonna take the shade Mistletoe again, the green shade. By the way, this shade Fairy Lights is what I just used in my inner corner. And this is of course the multi-chrome shade. I'm just gonna apply that green to the lower lash line. It's a bit of a mess under my eye, but I will clean it up in a bit. I think I like the blue better than the green. Of course, there's something to say for the green that is so buildable, but I feel like the blue looks a little bit more smooth. But now that I am kind of adding to the green, I feel like it looks more smooth. But you kind of have to work a little bit to make it look as smooth as I would want. It's not like an effortless blend. I'm not saying that it's a bad eyeshadow, I wouldn't say that, but I just like the blue more than this one. I'm just gonna take a little bit of the blue in the outer corner, matching the top to the bottom. I just really like the combination of that blue and that green, because they don't blend into each other too much, but it looks very good together. I feel like maybe the contrast between the top and the bottom is a little bit too big, so I'm just gonna take a little bit of the blue and apply it over here as well to add a little bit of shadow here. Yeah, I like that better. Just gonna do that over here as well. Just a little bit of a smoky liner, not too precise or anything. Okay, so this is what the eyeshadow looks like right now. I'm just gonna finish up the makeup. I'm gonna clean up under my eyes a little bit, and then I will be right back with my first impression thoughts. So this is the finished look, and I actually love how this turned out. This eyeshadow is next level. It's so impactful, it's so sparkly, it's so shimmery. I added a little bit of the multichrome on the lower lash line just now because I felt like it needed a little bit of shimmer on the lower lash line as well, but I really really love these shades, these shimmers. This was such an easy look to do. So I'm actually really impressed with this palette. The only thing that I have to mention is that this green shade was a little bit less pigmented, a little bit less creamy than the blue. Of course, I haven't tried these two mattes, so I can't really say anything yet about all the mattes overall, but I'm very excited to try this palette more, to use it more. I'm very, very impressed. I think this is so pretty. This bobble shade, I looked in the mirror and I don't feel like it looks exactly the same as the shade in the Giant Wolves palette. The shade that I'm talking about is Eternal. I don't think they are complete dupes, but they have a similar vibe. They have similar shades in there, like similar shifts, but I feel like this one is a little bit more bright green, the one that I have on right now, and it is a lot more sparkly. This is kind of sparkly in a smooth way. This multi-chrome is, let me just swatch it. It is not extremely gritty or sparkly. When you swatch it, you can see it looks very, very smooth, but it kind of has those same shifts though. It's a similar vibe. Let me just swatch the bobble shade. It feels a lot more gritty. So the formulas are different, but now that I look at them on my fingers, it is like they are the same, but then the finish is different. So we have the Glaminatrix shade over here, and then we have the shade from the Giant Wolves palette over here. These are so similar, actually. I was thinking this was a little bit less bright green, but looking at these on my finger, I think this could play a very, very similar role in a look. It's just that those textures are very, very different. But they are so, so similar. Like the light blue, the purple, the pink, the gold, and then that green. So this is an interesting thing to know. If you're eyeing the Giant Wolves palette and you are eyeing that multi-chrome, you can get this bobble shade as a single. So you can just get that one and have that shade basically, but only more sparkly. So yeah, all in all, I think this is a very beautiful palette. It's very pretty. It's very small and compact. It's very convenient. And I think the way they did the packaging, it's very tasteful. It's not like bam in your face, gingerbread house, ginger cookie, things like that. It's not like two-faced. It is very tasteful. It is very pretty. So I can actually see myself reaching for this later on in the year as well, but we're gonna see how it's gonna go. But I can't imagine that I would wouldn't want to play more with these pretty shades later on in the year. So those are my thoughts so far on the Silent Night eyeshadow palette by Glamanatrix. Of course, this is a first impression. I haven't tried out all the shades, so I'm gonna be testing out a little bit more, and then I will come back to you with my final thoughts, how I actually feel after using it a few times more. And I always come back to these things in my new makeup ranking, so keep an eye out for that video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. And don't forget to subscribe. And also let me know in the comments if you've picked up this palette. Are you eyeing it? And then I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.